In this video, we're going to learn how to update existing record in Salesforce using Flows. The business use case is, on an opportunity, you may have got many fields, but for a particular stage, only few fields need to be filled in. Now, from a Salesforce user perspective, he has to go and search for those particular fields. Now, to make their life easy, we can create a screen flow where, based on a particular stage pick list value, only the predetermined field will be displayed, and that needs to be filled in by the sales user. For example, if we have an opportunity, let's take for example, and if I edit this opportunity, then I've got so many fields over there. But what if, based on the stage, for example, prospecting, I'm just supposed to fill up the type and lead source. Whereas, when the stage is value proposition, I'm expected to fill in the main competitors and the current generators. Now, this is something which we are going to achieve by using Flow. To make use of Flow, the design would be, we will have a variable where we are going to store the opportunity ID. Since this flow will be kicked from the opportunity page layout by clicking a button, we first need to capture the opportunity ID of that record. Once that is stored in a variable, then we will get the entire record for that opportunity in a new record variable. Then we will make use of decision element based on the stage pick list value. We are going to show them a different screen, and each screen will have the fields which are applicable for the selected stage. Then we'll update the record, we will debug it, and then we'll call flow from custom button. So let's go to flow. And let's create a new flow now. It would be screen flow since we are going to launch it from a custom button. The very first step would be to create a resource. Resource is something, it can be a variable, it can be constant. For our example, a variable, and we will call it as opportunity ID. And we will say it is of type text. And it has to be available for input and output. The second resource we are going to create would be a record variable. So, say variable, say opportunity record. Data type would be record, and this would be for opportunity. So far what we have done, we have created two variables. Now, if I look into the elements, we have to get the records. So I'll say get records. I'll say get opportunity. We have to get for the object opportunity. We will get an opportunity where the ID equals the variable that we just created. Now this is something which we are going to pass it through the URL. And then we have to then go and save this particular thing. So say ID. And we are going to save it. So just to reiterate what we have done so far, we first went ahead and created two variables. The opportunity ID is a text variable. This is the opportunity ID that we are going to pass through the URL. The data or the record is going to get saved in a variable by name opportunity record. Then we are going to use the element, get element. We are saying go to that opportunity, find out the record where the opportunity ID that we are passing is there in the system, and then store it in a record variable, opportunity record. We'll say done. Now the next part would be to make sure that we can do a decision. So let's decision. So we will say stage value. And we are going to give a label to it. Now let's look at what all stages we have it on an opportunity. So let's go and say setup. So we have a stage by name prospecting. Let's copy that. So when the resource, what we are going to say over here is when opportunity record dot stage equals prospecting, then we need to do something. So we'll say done. So to reiterate, this is a decision element. We are saying whenever the opportunity stage name equals prospecting, do something. And do something is what? We are going to now display the fields which needs to be filled up only when the stage picklist value is prospecting. To do that, we will make use of screen. So let's drag and drop screen. So we'll say opportunity screen. And take for example, for this, we just want to make sure that let's first have a text one. And then we are going to create the fields that needs to be filled in whenever the opportunity is in prospecting stage. So let's go back to an opportunity and look at the fields that we have over here. Take for example, we want just amount and close date to be filled in. So amount is my currency. I'll say currency. I'll give a label as amount. And the default value has to come from the opportunity record variable. Amount over here. And the second one is, let's take for example, for text, we will say, let it be type. Over here, type is a pick list, lead source also a pick list. Let's order number. Let's take for example order number. Say order number. And over here we'll say opportunity record dot order number. So these two fields needs to be filled in whenever the opportunity value stage picklist value is prospecting.